This is Lewis with Gold Plating Services. Today we're going to show you how we plate with rose gold. We're going to take this bell here and we're going to put a very nice rose gold finish on it. To do that, we're using four different solutions today. We have our electro cleaner, Trival, our gel brush gold, and a brush rose gold. We got Rob over here who's going to be doing the plating for us. And he'll tell you a little bit more about it as he goes.
All right, first we gotta find a spot to clip. I'll get right here. All right, this is the regular universal plater. We've got the voltage set to 8.3 before. It'll drop down to around 7 while plating, which is what we're looking for. So we're gonna go ahead and electroclean it. I'm actually going to break this bell in half just to make it go smoother and increase the chances of getting a good job. If you try and do too big of an area in an odd shape like this all in one go, you can encounter some issues. We're going to be featuring the Trival today instead of the regular Woods Nickel Strike that a lot of people use on stainless steel. I like Trival a lot. I like it more than the Woods Nickel Strike. They both do the same job. Difference is the Trival delivers a gold strike instead of nickel. And especially if it were a piece of jewelry or something, that's really important. But the other big thing is, which you'll see in a minute, is that it actually applies a thin layer of gold. And so you're able to see that the area struck well. That's really weird that it didn't wet out. Let's go on and see what happened. I'm going to leave the same voltage and hit it with the Trival. I'm wondering if this item may be chrome plated, even though it said it was stainless steel. It's very odd that it didn't wet out from the electro cleaner, but is taking the strike. As you see, it's turning a gold color. Let's just move on and see what happens. That does happen in this line of work. Stuff will be labeled as one thing and it turns out it's got a coating or something on it. Trival, as an interesting point, will actually plate directly onto chrome. You don't want to do it as a matter of practice because what happens is eventually the chrome will actually kind of, and I don't know how to explain it on a electrochemical level, but eventually the gold will fall off sooner than if you strip the chrome and plate the nickel. Back in the late 90s, people started trying to skip stripping the nickel, the chrome, and just going straight over it with a gold strike. And that's why gold packages, you'll see people driving around with really ugly gold packages on their cars, and it's because they didn't strip the chrome. They thought they were saving a step and really it compromises the quality. But for this video, we're more interested in showing you what the rose gold looks like. So I'm just gonna proceed, even though that was a complete surprise. Let's get it all struck real quick and then we'll gold plate it and then we'll put on rose gold. Now, a lot of people ask us, do I have to gold plate it first before I put the rose gold on? The answer technically is no, you do not. You can still get the gold to go on. But as a matter of practice, it's an industry standard practice to put yellow gold underneath rose gold. As for why, I would say it's because your chances of getting a good rose gold plate are better. Also, I guess if the rose gold were to ever wear off, you have yellow gold underneath instead of a silver color, which is more of a contrast. All right, that's struck well enough, I would think. Let's go ahead and put a yellow gold plate on and then we'll show you what the rose gold looks like. I'm gonna turn the voltage down just a little bit. And we'll go ahead and yellow gold plate it. It should be turning gold really fast. I mean, it already was tinted, but this is definitely a darker, deeper, rich yellow gold color that this will apply. And since we're going to be rose gold plating it, I'm just going to put a thin layer on here. This could be someone's Mother's Day gift, as we got Mother's Day coming up. If their mom was a secretary or something, she could have a rose gold bell. All right, let's rinse it off. Okay, now we've got it generally gold plated. If I were doing this for a customer, I would certainly spend a little bit more time and do a little bit better job for them. Okay, so now I'm gonna take the handle from the gold, put it down here to the rose gold, and let's see how it goes. See it turning that pink color. It's not quite as quick as the yellow gold is, but it, as you see, it goes on pretty quickly. It's not slow by any means. We're operating right now at about 5.5 volts. While plating. If I was gonna do this again, I'd probably use a woolly sleeve for all the solutions, just to get some better, you know, quicker coverage of the area, carries more solution. But yeah, as you can see, it has like a nice pink coppery color that people are really into these days. And especially with Mother's Day coming up, a lot of jewelers are doing rose gold. And there you have it. I hope you can see the color of the rose gold. Still a little bit of yellow gold on that stem to compare it to. And that's it. That's our rose gold plating solution for you. And go ahead and comment, like, and subscribe to our channel. Let us know if you have any questions about it. And give us a call. Thank you.